Hello, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Sam Harkin, and I am... I don't know, I'm okay. Turn this down a bit. Hello, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Sam Harkin, and I'm feeling... I'm feeling okay. I mean, I didn't really do too much today. And I mean... As I said, I like to be productive, so... Yeah, when I don't really do much. Like, the thing is, I can have, like, days where I'm like, oh, I'm gonna just relax today. But, quite a lot of the time, that doesn't happen. It's just kind of like, I'm gonna work today, and then I don't end up doing it. So, like, it's really weird. Like, there's such a fine line between a relaxing day and a day where I do nothing and I get all antsy about it. And that difference is pretty much whether or not I go from the outset of being like, yes, this is a day I'm taking off. So yeah, so I mean, I felt better. It's not actually going to be a very long video though, because I've been working on editing videos and stuff, so this isn't going to be terribly long. So let's see where we are. We basically are just kind of like, should we look for another job? Here's the thing, I think I would be very terrified, because the thing is, I'd love to look through, like, aimlessly look through that kind of stuff, but the thing is, that kind of stuff stresses me out, and I guess having a job already, I'd be kind of a bit more likely to be just like, should just stick it out, even though I know that in the long run that would completely screw me over, because, I mean, I always just put that stuff off, like, I'd be just like, oh, I'll do it tomorrow night, I'll do it tomorrow. So I'm going to say that I'm going to do my project, and it's probably not going to work. You sit down at your computer to blow up some steam, but are surprised to find your thoughts drifting to your long-neglected project. Okay, so it's drifting towards and so away, so that's fairly good, I guess. You talk yourself into opening it up and taking a look for the first time in what must be weeks. For whatever reason, your anger that you've been feeling towards your day job seems to have converted into pure passion. Yes! As you seem to be overflowing with ideas tonight. Good. It's as if you've got a build-up of ideas that you just haven't gotten out, and now you're in the zone. So I really love that feeling. Like, quite a lot of the time, even when I am doing stuff, I'm kind of... Like, even when I was, like, cooking and stuff today, I was kind of, like, in the back of my mind, oh my god, what about my life and stuff? It was a really weird day, actually, because, I mean, there were times that I was just completely, like, oh yeah, I'm completely on top of everything. And other times where I just kind of thought about it for a second, I was like, no, I don't have anything together. So it's kind of weird. I think a good chunk of it is just whether or not I decide to feed that kind of negative part of my mind, I guess. Even though to an extent it still makes sense that I have that, because I still don't really know where I'm going. So I think it's understandable to be a bit distraught in that kind of situation, I guess. While you don't get an unnatural amount of work done, you do work for a solid couple of hours and it really feels great. What's more, you share some stuff across your social media networks and you receive quite a bit of positive feedback, which makes you feel great. When you go top bed, I believe that's to bed that night, you tell yourself that your job may suck, but at least you've got something you really care about that you can put effort into and feel really good about yourself. In fact, as you're falling asleep, you can barely remember your work day. That's kind of how I feel about YouTube. Like, don't get me wrong, it's totally exhausting sometimes, and it can be very discouraging, especially because, like, for example, I posted, like, my first kind of video that I've been, like, legitimately proud of in a while, because pretty much everything I've been posting has been reviews and stuff. And I posted, like, a rants thing, and I was like, oh, I actually put effort into this, I actually, like, wrote notes for this and stuff, and... As I was uploading it, I was like, I've lost a subscriber. And then, like, I've checked it a couple of days ago and only got, like, 5 views. Which I know isn't important in the grand scheme of things. But it's hard to be in a situation where you're putting that kind of stuff out there and not be a bit kind of like, oh, I thought I'd get a bit more than that. I thought it was pretty good. And it's especially hard when it's a small YouTuber because you never get any feedback, and if you ever do, it's either A, from people who you know are going to say nice things regardless, or it's just, like, really hateful, like, oh, God, like, kill yourself and stuff. Like, that's a bit harsh. Okay. It's a little past 8 p.m. on a Tuesday night. You're at your computer, frustration levels peaked, rubbing your eyes and sighing heavily. You're working on a project from your job. Oh, God. That would be awful to have like, homework. It's bad enough at school, but at a job that you hate. Jesus. That has a project from your job that has you stretched to your wit's end, trying to meet a looming deadline as it lurks closer and closer, you are seriously doubting your ability to get it done. So accurate, you've been dragging your feet a little at work due to your complete lack of energy lately, in spite of wanting to do a good job. You find yourself unable to push past it and feel horribly useless for it. You slide your hands off your face to look at your screen as it beeps at you. Eric, hey, are you there? Eric, I really need to talk to someone about something. You feel like you're getting nowhere with your current task and could probably use a break. However, you know that you have a history of getting distracted and then losing motivation to pick something back up again afterwards. Okay. Let's see. What would I do in this situation? We can tell Attic we're busy, we can try and regain your focus by not even answering, or we can answer. I'm going to be honest, I think even though I totally get this perspective of like, oh no, just I can't do any of this stuff, taking a break and then just like not coming back to it for ages, I'd probably answer, because I mean, we're pretty good friends and he was the one who suggested we go to a therapist and medication and this stuff's kind of helping, I assume. You're feeling like you've hit a brick wall with your task, so why not take a break and help out a friend? Hey, what's up? Oh, good, you're there. I just found out I got cheated on. I don't know what to do. Oh no, that's horrible. So, that's Attic who got cheated on. The two of you talk for a long time and you lend a shoulder for your friend. You give him space to rant, to cry, and most importantly, to be able to voice his inner turmoil. You give him your full attention and talk him through what his options are for what he does next. Oh, we didn't actually do... Oh, we actually do. Wait, I just read ahead. I'm sorry. Stick to the story. You keep him from doing something rash, and the two of you decide it's best for him to sleep on it before doing anything. Exhausted, he departs for bed and thanks you for being there to talk with him. As you close the IM window, you feel horribly sorry for your friend, but happy that you are able to help. It serves as a tangible reminder that to you that you're capable of being useful to someone instead of solely being a mess that needs everyone's help. Yeah. And I think if nothing else, like, if you're, like, stressed and frustrated and stuff, just being able to, like, chat to someone about, like, how you feel, even if you don't go, like, full rant, because, I mean, as a friend, Tiger, hey, Tiger, like, that helps so much. It's just, like, a simple little thing. Like, I don't even go, like, super deep and, like, oh, what is the purpose of life, existentialism, blah. But it's just nice to be able to chat to someone who kind of gets it. Though, admittedly, only because I've only told him. You boot up your work project and find that you're suddenly able to get some solid progress done on it that night. Very nice. It's a sunny Saturday afternoon. You're deep in thought on the way home from therapy. However, you notice this time that you're not in the same negative feedback loops you usually get trapped in when being this introspective. You notice that although you've still had your bad days, your lows aren't quite as low as they used to be. Your antidepressants bottle rolls across your dashboard as you take a left turn. You've been on this medication for quite a while now, after a period of trying a few different kinds, though you still have minor side effects that overall become an unnoticed part of your life. You feel as if your life has generally changed for the better recently, and you begin to wonder if you need them anymore. You don't feel as much despair or hopelessness, and you hate yourself a lot less these days. Good, good positive stuff. Maybe it's time to stop taking these, you think. I seem to not really need them anymore. What do you do? We can continue, or we can just go off. So I'm going to let you guys tell me what you think that you would do in the comment section down below. And I will see you guys soon, and subscribe and do that, and yeah, I'll see you soon, bye!